I'm back. Inventory two. Now we're going to talk about some methods we can cost out our inventory and get our cost of goods sold using. The first thing I'm going to do is propose a little problem that is also in my lecture notes if you have access to those. It's Maggie's lemonade stand. Now my daughter Maggie was busy selling lemonade and she moved to the clubhouse and started selling sodas. So all sodas were basically the same that she was selling. So she paid different, at different times she bought different batches of sodas. So I wanted you to see that what we could do with that using these methods. So the first example is the same one that's in the lecture notes. So if you want the hard copy, you can go look at that. How to cost out if all products are the same. Now, if these sodas were all different, we wouldn't have this issue because we could tell one brand from another, but they're all the same. So she can't tell when she puts them in the cooler what she's got in there. So when she pulls it out, she doesn't really know which one she's using. So these methods are an allocation method, not specifically identifiable. That's for something like cars or something. So we are going to skip that method. I'll mention it, but I want to talk about the others. But let me just set up the problem. So she starts a little lemonade stand, and on August the 1st, if you can see the dates, she buys 36 cans for 40 cents a piece and pays $14.40. Then she goes back on the 10th, and the price has changed because she got them on sale, and she's bought 50 of them for 35 cents and paid $17.50. Good shopper. Then on the 15th, she bought 48 cans, paid 32 cents, and a total of $15.36. So all in all, she has got 134 units ready to sell of her sodas, and the cost of those units, or the COGAS, or the cost of goods available to sell, is $47.26. So she has $47.26 invested in that inventory, ready to sell. So now she's gonna sell some during the summer. So my problem is, if she sells 50, how many will be left? So first of all, from a unit standpoint, that's pretty easy to tell. So if we had 134 units and we sell 50, you can do that math. 134 minus 50, then 84 will be left. So things have got to be in either ending inventory or they're sold. Remember, what was that equation? Beginning inventory plus purchases, which is cost of goods available for sale, minus inventory is equal to cost of goods sold, minus ending inventory is equal to cost of goods sold, or beginning inventory plus purchases minus cost of goods sold is equal to ending inventory. And we talk a little bit about perpetual inventory versus periodic inventory. In small businesses or in old days, they didn't have computers to keep up with their inventory. So they would do a count at the end of the period, like a physical inventory, and most of you have done this. A lot of bars do this. A lot of little stores just count to see what they have. And then they assume, if they know what they started with and they know what they have at the end, that the rest of it must be sold. So that's how they cost out, using that method of backing in to the sales. So we're going to cost out the ending inventory and subtract it from cost of goods sold if we're using the periodic inventory method. Nowadays, you walk in the grocery store and a person scans everything. So a lot of grocery stores and most companies can use the perpetual method because they can identify by barcode exactly what's sold. So that's a little bit harder, but it's very easy from a conceptual standpoint. So we're going to just talk in theory, and then later on you can get into the depths of perpetual versus periodic, which we'll do. Okay, ready? So the first example I want to show you is weighted average. Now that to me makes the most sense. I like averages, and I like weighting averages. Oops. And I like turning pages that don't flop over. So again, we've got our same example up here. And I want to just have specific identification over on the side saying I'm not going to use that in this. So I've got FIFO, LIFO, and weighted average I want to talk about. But first I'm going to talk about weighted average. So in weighted average inventory, we're going to put the same weight on every unit. So I'm going to take my cost of goods available for sale, $47.26, that I told you about a few minutes ago, and divide it by my units available for sale to get 35 cents or 0.353. Now, I didn't buy any one unit at 0.353. That is just weighting the amount of the expensive ones and the less expensive ones to get an average. And that's what weighting does, is puts the weight based on it. Okay, we ready to do that one? I need to stop here though.